I wish I could make reaction videos, but I was born in 1956. I've heard all these songs. What could I possibly react to?
Hey, whippersnappers. Brian here to Boomer Reacts. Welcome back. If this is your first time here, thanks for checking me out. I listen to rap and hip-hop songs using lyric videos, and then I let you know what I thought about them. As you can see, I'm going to be reacting to For Better or For Worse by The Far Side. And the fours, the F-O-Rs, are actually the number four. For Better or For Worse. Let's see, I've reacted to The Far Side before. I did Passing Me By from their debut album, Bizarre Ride to the Far Side. For Better or For Worse is on this also. What else did I do? I did Runnin', and that was on their second album, Lab Cabin California. So the group is from South Central. It's Slim Kid 3, Booty Brown, Imani, and Fat Lip. About For Better or For Worse, Slim Kid 3 says, quote, "This is one of those songs that J. Swift created on his own. Those chords are his. And just the way it sounds is like a marriage, a wedding or something." Oh, For Better or For Worse. I get it. When we started with Reggie Andrews at the studio, the loops of the song we were doing would play all day throughout the studio. Fat Lip went about it like a stalker or something, not locked in a room, but in this room doing this character, and we were like, fuck it. I really appreciate how wild we were. Everything was fun, and it turned out to be this really crazy, cool, fucking music." Unquote. The song was produced by J. Swift and released as the third single. All right. For Better or For Worse, it didn't even occur to me, you know, a marriage until he said the music for the loops kind of sounded like a wedding. The chords. J. Swift's chord sounded like a wedding. Okay.
Do you take Rhymalinda to be your lovely wedding wife? I do.
Pants.
Well, that literally went from best to worst, because that last verse by Fat Lip and then the outro, you know, I understand the progression, but, you know, that verse was just like annoying. I was enjoying the song up until then. I think they could have done something better to illustrate worst. It didn't have to be like a crazy person calling this woman's house. But the beat was fun. It's one of those memorable beats, and that's what you always want on a song. So the progression, the first verse was, you know, Slim Kid 3, and he was his was, you know, the best. He was looking forward to getting married. And he loved her, and they're going to have kids, and, you know, the whole nine yards. And then Imani's was, I'm not sure what the problem was. There was a problem, but I'm not sure what the problem was. It wasn't, the relationship wasn't the worst, but it wasn't the best. And then Fat Lips, you know, I don't even know where that came from. And that outro made no sense to me either. It's just, you know, it was too much at the end, for me anyway. If he had, you know, done something a little more creative than being a psycho, you know, calling this woman's house, I would have preferred that. But, you know, it is what it is. It's not going to go in my car. Only because of Fat Lip's part. It's just, you know, too harsh and not lyrically intelligent enough, in my opinion, to put in the car. So it gets three quarters approval. three quarters approval. No, not even. I guess a third, two-thirds approval. There you go, two-thirds. Because of the three verses, two were good, and one was eh, and the outro, eh. Well, thanks for hanging with me, guys. If you like this kind of content, give me a like and a subscribe. I'll see you on the next video. Bye.